Hello, in this quick video, we're going to take a look at how to join and use a Zoom meeting. To begin, you will need the meeting URL. If you are the person who created the meeting room, this can be found by logging into case.edu/zoom, selecting meetings on the left of the page, then locating your meeting. Click on its name, then copy the join URL. This is also the link that you can share with students so they can join the meeting. With the link copied, navigate to the URL in a web browser. While you can use the Zoom app on your mobile device and Wi-Fi, we do not recommend these options. Using a wired internet connection on a computer will give you the most stable meeting experience. Once the meeting page loads, you will be prompted to download and run the Zoom client. Save this file to your computer and follow the setup instructions on the screen. Once the client has successfully installed, your meeting will launch. If your client does not work properly, click on the link at the bottom of the page to run the lighter version of the Zoom meeting from your browser. Once the meeting launches, you will be asked to connect to the meeting audio. Select if you'd like to connect with your phone or with your computer microphone and speakers. If you choose to connect with your computer, we recommend testing your mic and speakers using the testing tool provided. As always, please use a headset or headphones in order to help avoid audio feedback. Once your audio is connected, you can mute and unmute yourself at any time by clicking the microphone button at the bottom of the screen. We recommend muting your mic if you're not speaking to help avoid any audio issues for the rest of the meeting participants. To start sharing your camera, click on the video button at the bottom of the screen. You can also stop sharing your camera by clicking on this button. Once the meeting has started, you can change your view of the meeting room. You can view everyone's cameras in speaker view, which highlights the active speaker as the largest camera, or switch to gallery view. Gallery view shows all of the cameras on one screen and highlights the active speaker with a border around their camera. You can also click on the full screen button to maximize the viewing space. Along the bottom of the meeting room are some additional options you'll find handy. The first is the participants list, which will show you who else is in the meeting. You have the ability here to mute attendees if they need to be muted. To do this, hover your cursor over their name and select the option to mute or unmute the user. You can also change a user's role in the room, upgrading them to a co-host. Co-hosts can help mute other users and manage the meeting settings. If you have a tech support person in your meeting, we ask that you change their role to co-host. To do this, hover your cursor over their name and select Make Co-host. They will then be listed as a co-host on the participants list. At the bottom of the meeting room, we can click to turn on the chat panel. This lets you send messages to other users in the room. You can choose to message the entire participants list or send a private message to select users using the To selector. Zoom also lets you share your screen by clicking on the Share Screen button. Select which screen you want to share on the pop-up that appears. Generally, I like to choose desktop so that users can see all of my windows and programs. When you start sharing your screen, the meeting room will condense and both you and your participants will see your screen. All of the meeting options can still be accessed from the top of the screen. When you're ready to stop sharing, click the Stop Share button. Finally, if you want to record your meeting, you can do so by clicking on the Record button. If you'd like a local copy of the recording file, choose to record on your local machine. Otherwise, you can record to the cloud and retrieve your recording later from case.edu/zoom. And that's it, all you need to know about getting started using Zoom. For any additional questions or concerns, please contact the UTech Service Desk at 368-HELP or at help.case.edu. Thanks for watching!